In this video, we will demonstrate the moving patella apprehension test for lateral patella instability. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to PhysioTutors. Patella dislocation can have several underlying anatomical factors, including but not limited to abnormal bony anatomy of the trochlea and patella, mechanical misalignment of the lower limb, as well as static and dynamic deficiency of soft tissue stabilizers. The traditional patella apprehension test, as well as CTs or MRI, may fail to detect patients with patella instability due to its static nature, especially outside of an acute event or if the patella failed to self-reduce. Any static testing of medial patellofemoral ligament laxity has been disappointing, according to Tanner et al. This is why Ahmad et al. In 2009 proposed the moving patella apprehension test to functionally mimic an actual dislocation or instability episode of the patella. In their diagnostic cohort study, they found an overall accuracy of 94.1% with a sensitivity of 100 and a specificity of 88.4%. The study has several limitations that, for example, exclude patients with symptomatic subluxations rather than frank dislocations, and the test has not been validated in other studies, which is why we give it a moderate clinical value. To conduct the test, the patient is in supine lying position with the lower leg hanging over the edge of the bench. In the first part of the test, the leg is in full extension and the examiner uses the thumb of one hand to translate the patella laterally. Then the leg is moved into 90 degrees of flexion and the examiner notes any signs of apprehension orally expressed by the patient or quadriceps contraction in an attempt to stop flexion and or to dynamically reposition the patella. It is then brought back into full extension while the lateral translation is maintained. In a second step, the knee is again in full extension, and now the examiner uses the index finger to medially translate the patella as far as possible. The knee is then again flexed to 90 degrees, and elimination of apprehension and/or quadriceps contraction is noted. In order for the test to be considered positive, both steps of the test have to be positive. Ahmad and colleagues state the following. In full knee extension, the patella is in its most unstable position and soft tissues and alignment are most responsible for the patella stability. As flexion begins, the patella must engage the trochlea and then stability is shared by the soft tissues, overall alignment, and the bony geometry of the trochlea and patella. For a knee without patella instability, as the knee flexes, the patella is guided into the trochlea by the MPFL and other medial soft tissue stabilizers. The patella subluxates most easily at 20% of knee flexion, and the MPFL seems to resist lateral patella subluxation greatest when the knee is towards full extension. For patients with symptomatic instability, while the knee is flexing combined with an eccentric quadriceps force, the patella engages the trochlea in a lateral position and then dislocates or subluxates as the knee continues to flex. For the patient with patella instability who is being evaluated with the moving patella apprehension test, as the knee flexes during the first part of the test, the patella engages the trochlea in a lateral position and mimics a patellar dislocation episode, therefore reproducing the symptoms associated with a dislocation. The moving patella apprehension test also actively assesses the MPFL, since the MPFL is responsible for guiding the patella properly into the trochlea as the knee moves from full extension into flexion. In the second part of the test, with medial force on the patella as the knee is flexed, the symptoms of impending dislocation are eliminated because the patella engages the trochlea in a normal fashion. The manual translation of the patella reproduces the function of the deficient and/or incompetent MPFL. The test is a combination of apprehension in part 1 and the reduction of the apprehension in part 2. This dynamic provocative test is similar in concept to the pivot shift test for the ACL in the knee and the release test for anterior shoulder instability, as well as the moving valgus stress test for valgus instability of the elbow. All tests which you can watch on our channel as well. All right, thanks a lot for watching this video. If you want to watch other videos on patella instability, check the videos on my left. As always, you can find all infos regarding the literature used for this video in the description down below, as well as links to other resources, such as our assessment ebook app and our online courses. This was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.